Hey, thanks for listening to our podcast. If you want to listen live in the central Indiana area, you can hear us on 93.5 FM and 107.5 FM.
Hey, it's Basketball Celebration Day, and Walter McCarty, the head coach of the Evansville Purple Aces, who beat the number one team in the country and his alma mater, the University of Kentucky, making all of you Indiana fans happy. Nice enough to join us now. Hey, boss, how great was the trip home?
Oh, it was awesome. It was awesome just to see the joy in our team. And I'm just so proud of just how they played. They were so connected, and it just felt really good.
Walter, when I was reading before the game and then after the game, you had talked about very confidently, great day to be, let's make this a great day to be, you know, Purple Aces, and you talked about your team. Was there something going into the game that you saw not only from your team, but maybe how you could play against Kentucky that gave you confidence going into the game?
Oh, definitely. I think just the way we play, the way they play. Like, we're a team that we're really connected. We move the ball. You know, they're very athletic, so they use their quickness and their like they get to the ball really fast. They try to go block shots. They try to get steals. They gamble a lot. So we value the basketball, and we just do what we do. Make the pass, extra pass, swing it. We're going to get wide open shots, and we were able to do that. We just have to make shots, and I trust my guys. We're in the gym a lot. They're in the gym. They love coming in and working. And we were just very fortunate, man. We made shots, and it was just one of those things where we were really, really connected.
I agreed with what Calipari said. Like, if they had won, they weren't the better team yesterday. This wasn't – and how much does this feel good for you? This wasn't one of those deals where you hit 20 out of 28 threes. You know what I mean? Like, that happens.
Right.
You know, this was – you outplayed the number one team in the country in their own gym.
Yeah, we're tough, man. Our thing was, man, keep it close on the first 2 or 3 minutes of the game. Keep the fans out of it. We can't give up dunks or fast breaks. We have to make sure we get back and just pack the paint. Make them beat us from taking long challenge shots. And man, our guys executed so well. I mean, they were really locked in. They did a good job in scouting the last 3 or 4 days of just really being locked in, where they were accountable for. They were starting to coach themselves, telling guys, "You need to be here. You need to be here." Well, we didn't have to say a word. So when they were doing that in practice, I knew we got a real shot.
Yeah, you played at Kentucky. You're a great player at Kentucky. Won national championship at Kentucky. You have been there when, you know, runs come. I played at Indiana, coached at Indiana, and you know, you're in Assembly Hall. The crowd's there. A run is going to come for the home team. It never came. Were you sitting there based on your experience at Rupp? Were you sitting there waiting, man, there's going to be a run. I know there is. You know, you were part of runs like that, and it just never came because of your guys.
Yeah, our guys, you know, they made some tough plays, but our guys, they never got rattled. They just kept battling. And you know, there was a time where, you know, we made mistakes where we didn't even get shots off, but a dead ball turnover is much better than a live ball, because they got no points out of it. And we were able to get back and set our defense and, you know, just really trust what we were doing. So we weren't concerned about the run. My guys were really locked in. And we were just really prepared, man. I think when you prepare as hard as we do and how they were that night, that you get a little confident. And I trusted my guys to make the right plays.
Well, they did. And, you know, I got to give Cunliffe credit. Now, this is a kid, he's on his third school. He had to step up in front of that crowd, man. That crowd's nasty, as you know better than anybody. He stepped up, made 2 free throws. He didn't put the game away because they had a chance to tie, but that's big time for that kid, is it not?
It's very big time. The kid's growing up. He's been through a lot, and he really loves being here. For a kid that never knew anything, knew where Evansville was, he's really embraced the city, this program, and he's grown up so much as a player and as a person that this is his time now, and he understands it. And he's been really good at just doing things our way and trusting us. And he's got out his own way, and he just trusts what we're doing. He's bought in, and he's having success. And it's awesome. I'm really so proud of him.
Hey, Walter, nobody listens to this show, so you don't have to worry about what you say. How cool.
I know better than that now.
How cool was it? Like, it's everybody's dream, right? You go back to your alma mater, you beat their ass, they're the number one team in the country on top. And for you personally, like, hey, I know you're a humble guy, but that's pretty cool, right? I mean, we're going in that locker room and seeing those kids douse you. I was at ESPN last night. How cool was that, man? Come on.
It was cool, man. We got a good group, man, and I love these kids. I'm not just saying that. We have a great group of guys, and just for them to experience that is something that they're going to remember for the rest of their lives. And I'm excited that they got to experience that, and they're going to tell that story forever.
It was pretty cool. I was sitting last night at ESPN in the studio, and they had cameras on you. And they had camera in the locker room before you got in there. And I thought it was very cool. I don't know if this is right or wrong, but it seemed like watching it, there were a lot of people, even Kentucky fans, that were very happy for you. I saw people, you know, older people giving you hugs, you know, right, that looked like Kentucky fans. That says a lot about you and the appreciation that Kentucky fans have for what you did as a player and how you were as a player. Talk about that for a second, if you don't mind, because I thought that was very cool.
It was awesome. From the moment we walked in, all the guys, all the people there from Kentucky, they were very gracious. They were welcoming, and I mean, it was unreal. Coach Kyle, I love him. Great guy. I appreciate him bringing us back in there. But the people, man, they tripped. The ovation that they gave me after they announced my name was just, it was just unreal. And but like you said, the people that were, even after the game, they were giving me hugs. They were saying congratulations, good job, you guys deserve it. I mean, I've never seen Kentucky fans do that.
Right. Right.
Man, I don't know. I wish I could tell you what it was, but it made me feel really good. That means, and I think when my players see that, they understand that, hey, coach must have been a really good guy. Must have did some good things for them to react that way, and hopefully, they can continue, and you know, we can build that here in Evansville.
Yeah, and you know, it was just fascinating because it wasn't on TV, but it was, I don't know what ESPN does, but Seth Greenberg and I were in the studio and we were just watching. And then I gotta tell you, man, your players, they were loading up for you. Because, like, they had a camera in the locker room and they were waiting on you, and guys were like, I'm gonna go over here and get this. No, wait, I'm gonna get this, you know what I mean? And then you just jump right into it. Take me through that, because that's kind of a new thing. I guarantee you, I know Coach Knight didn't do that with us, and I probably Patino, you didn't douse him very often, you know.
We did not.
Right.
We did not.
That's a new,
so
cool thing.
I'm walking back there. I know they're going to do something, and I'm trying to peek around the corner. And I'm expecting the Gatorade tub or something like that. So I walk in. I mean, they got me cornered like it's they're out doing like a paintball or something.
Right.
They're just hitting me from everywhere. And it was just water bottles, and I'm drenched like I had just jumped in the pool or something. I'm like, how the heck did they drench me with water bottles like that? But it was awesome. They enjoyed it, man. And the funnest thing of the night that made the night is we give a toughness belt award out each game. It's one of those WWE belts that's decked out. And last night was so crazy. I actually forgot to do it. And we get on the bus, we're halfway back home, and a couple of players come up and say, Coach, hey, we want to see you in the back. I'm like, okay, they want something. They want the tomorrow off.
Right.
Pizza party or something.
Yeah.
They want something. So I walk back there, and KJ says, Coach, you know, you're always talking about toughness. I'm like, oh, man, they must have saw me get emotional and cry. They get ready, you know, get on me about it. And it's like, Coach, you got the toughness award.
Wow.
And they gave me the belt. And it was just so cool.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the cool stuff of coaching, man, right there, right? I mean, that's the fun stuff, right? The stuff people don't necessarily see all the time.
It was awesome, man. That just shows you what type of group we have. They're all bought in. And, man, hopefully this is just the beginning.
Yeah. Well, hey, I don't want to take up your time. I know you're swamped today, but I also got to tell you, man, for a Kentucky dude, you made the entire Indiana, state of Indiana, happy. I mean, I guess at Assembly Hall, they were chanting Evansville. I was on a plane this morning coming back, and the stewardesses are like, hey, did you see what Evansville did last? I mean, you made the entire state, man, seriously.
That's awesome, man. It's huge for our program. It really is.
Yeah. So. Yeah, well,
thank you.
Yeah, congratulations, Walter. I'm really happy for you, man, and good luck to you the rest of the way. Thank you so
thank
much
you.
For
I
taking
it.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
You got it.
All right, that's Coach Walter McCarty.